Welcome to Engineering Python. This is a Python programming course for engineers. In this video, I will continue to discuss GUI programming using PyQt and Qt Designer, where we create a simple, rich text editor. The text editor can do basic text editing. You can change the size of the window, change the font, change the color, open a file, and save a file. The following widgets are used: QMain window, QTextEdit, QManual, QManualBar, QAction, QFileDialog, QFontDialog, QColorDialog, QCheckbox, and QMessageBox. We will use the GUI development flow I introduced in a previous video to develop this program. Step 1 is to design the interface in Qt Designer. To start Qt Designer, you can type in Designer in the Windows Start menu. For macOS, type in Open-A Designer in a terminal to launch Qt Designer. In this new form dialog, because I have already created the UI, I'll just open it from my folder. Next, I'll briefly describe what I did when I created this graphic user interface. I clicked the empty space in the main window. In the property editor, set the main window's geometry width to 400, height to 300. Set the window title to Simple Editor. In the object inspector, there was originally a status bar. I just right-clicked and removed it, so you don't see it here. We don't need it in this program. I double-clicked the menu bar and changed the text to File. I added three actions under File, Open, Save, and Exit. I added another menu, Edit, and two actions under Edit, Font and Color. In the widget box, I searched for a checkbox. Drag and drop this widget to the main window. I double-clicked and changed the text to larger window. So if this box is checked, the size of the main window will be enlarged. If it's unchecked, the size will be back to this small window size. I searched for text edit in the widget box. Drag and drop a text edit into the main window. Let me break out this layout first. Then what I did was use Ctrl+A to select both widgets and click this layout vertically button. Click an empty area in the main window and click this Layout in a Grid button. You can preview this interface by pressing Ctrl+R. It doesn't do anything yet. We'll write code to process the click of this checkbox and the menu bar actions later. After we are done, we save the interface as editor-gui.ui. It's an XML document. Step 2 is to convert the UI file to a Python file using the following command in the command prompt or terminal: PyUIC5-x editor-gui.ui-o editor-gui.py. After that, we will get this Python file editor-gui.py. You can open this Python file and see the content. The entire window is an instance of this UI main window class. You can find all the widgets we added to the interface in this setUI function, like the grid layout, the checkbox, the text edit, the menu bar, and the actions. Some of the properties are defined in this retranslateUI function. Don't change anything in this Python file. Step 3 is to code in Python. We need to create a new file named editor.py. I already did that, so I'll just open my file. In the first line of this file, we need to import everything from editor GUI. Then we will define the signals function to deal with the signals passed by the widgets. We connected the open actions triggered signal to a user-defined file open function. An action is triggered when the menu item is clicked. I connected the save actions triggered signal to a user-defined file save function. we connect the quit action's triggered signal to a user-defined file quit function. Next, we connect the font action's triggered signal to a user-defined edit font function. We connect the color action's triggered signal to a user-defined edit color function. We connect the checkbox state changed signal to a user-defined enlarge window function. The checkbox state will change from checked to unchecked or vice versa when it's clicked. In this file open function, we will show a file dialog and ask the user to select which file to open. If the user selected file, the length of the file name will be greater than 0. We will use the with statement to open the file, read the content, and show the content in the text edit. In this file save function, we will show a file dialog and ask the user to enter a file name to save. If the length of the file name is greater than 0, we will use the with statement to create the file and write the content as rich text to this file using 2HTML. Rich text means the formatting like the font, the size, the color is also saved to the file. We can also save it as plain text without formatting. In this file quit function, we will show a message box and ask the user whether they really want to quit. The program will end only if they click the yes button. In this edit font function, we will show a font dialog and ask the user to select a new font. If the new font is valid, we will set the font of the entire text to the new font. In this edit color function, and ask the user to select a new color. If the new color is valid, we will set the color of currently selected text to the new color. In this enlarge window function, if the checkbox is checked, we will move the main window's top left corner to 100 points to the left of the screen and 100 points to the top of the screen. We will also set the size of the window to 600 by 400. If the checkbox is unchecked, we will set the size of the window to 400 by 300. Next, we need to add these 7 self-defined functions as new attributes in the UI main window class. The rest of the code has been explained in the previous calculator example in this course. I will not repeat them here. Step 4 is to execute this program. We do it in Jupyter Notebook using the run magic. Click the window to make it larger. Click it again to make it smaller. Click Menu, File, Open, and choose the then of Python. You will see the file's content. Click Menu, Edit Font, choose Consolus, size is 12, and click OK. The font is changed. Select the first line of the text edit. Click Menu, Edit Color. Choose Red and click OK. Unselect the first line. Now the text is changed to red. Click File, Save, and save it as the Zen of Python formatted.txt. After you are done, click Menu, File, Quit. The program will end. Okay, that was how to use PyQt and Qt Designer to create a simple text editor. The course materials are available on YouTube and GitHub. You can watch the course videos in sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. I'm Yong Wang. Thanks for watching.